President Uhuru Kenyatta has promised to reach out to all Kenyans in his second term once he is sworn into office on Tuesday. State House spokesman Manoa Isipizo on Tuesday said President Kenyatta was willing to lead the healing needed after a protracted poll dispute. Swearing in. The president would like to assure all Kenyans, those who voted for him and those who did not, that he will be president of all Kenyans. No one should fear that they will be marginalized or penalized for their political choice, Mr. Isipizu told journalists at the steps of Harambee House, which houses the president's office. Next week, the president will take his oath of office. On that day, he will rededicate himself to the path of peace, prosperity, constitutional order, and of healing. President Kenyatta will be sworn in on Tuesday, November 28, by the Chief Registrar of the Judiciary Anna Mahdi in the presence of Chief Justice David Maraga, who on Monday led a six-judge Supreme Court bench to unanimously uphold his election victory on October 26. Former Prime Minister and Mr. Kenyatta's arch-rival Raila Odinga withdrew from the repeat poll after successfully petitioning the president's August 8 win. Triumph. The NASA leader has demanded a fresh, credible election under a new electoral commission, saying it was the only way for the country to move forward. Further, Mr. Odinga has rubbished the Monday Supreme Court judgment, saying it was given by judges under duress. But in the statement, State House termed the decision as a triumph of the rule of law. The ruling of the Supreme Court yesterday is a vote for the constitutional path. It is a resounding triumph of the rule of law over the tragedy of chaotic disorder. The Supreme Court has affirmed the path designed by the architects of our republic, a path governed by constitutional institutions and the rule of law, a path whose end is order, stability and prosperity for our great nation, Mr. Isipizu said. 40 countries. He went on, faced with a choice between constitutional order and lawlessness, we have chosen the rule of law. Faced with a choice between mediating political differences by law, or by force and street protest, we have chosen the constitutional order. That, in the president's view, is the only way forward. Mr. Isipizu said that the president was now focused on his second term, whose priorities he will release when he addresses the nation during his swearing-in. Some of you have asked about how many countries have congratulated the president on his re-election. As of yesterday, we can confirm that more than 40 countries had done so. The foreign ministry will release details in due course. Essentially, these congratulatory messages are normally channeled through the Ministry of Foreign Affairs, said the State House spokesman.